evening, Holdings Forum. My name is David Fisher. I reside at 36 First Avenue in the lovely city of Woonsocket. I'm really glad a lot of people came out to this tonight. I sense a theme that I wanted to touch on that a lot of people here have spoken about. But first and foremost, this deal is why I have attempted to run for your seats. This is short-term thinking in its worst. How much actual tax relief is this plan going? And before you start writing questions down, these are actually rhetorical questions. I don't need to just them. How much actual tax relief is this deal going to bring to the city of Woonsocket, to each of these individuals that's paying thousands and thousands of dollars, $20 a quarter, $30 a quarter? Is $160 a year in tax relief worth this deal? With the rise of renewable energy coming up, solar is now the cheapest form of electricity produced in this country. We just built the first offshore wind turbine farm in the country off the coast of Rhode Island. And I tell you this right now, City Council members and Mrs. Mayor, if this plant gets built, I will bet any of you any amount of money that it will be shuttered in 20 years. I guarantee you that. As far as the financial impact of this goes, this is insane for this city to do this. When are we as a city, by we, I mean you all, going to figure out that we cannot go for the quick fix, silver mythical bullet that doesn't exist ever at any time or will in the future? This is not some panacea that we can put on the city's tax problems. It just does not work that way. We tried to do it with a sewage treatment plant that now stinks up half the downtown. It's a half a mile away from our beautiful new middle school. As far as Invenergy's priorities go, their only priorities, folks, are to their shareholders. They do not care about the city of Woonsocket, the state of Rhode Island. Their only responsibility is to produce profits for their shareholders. So go home and think about that. Lastly, we've talked over and over about improving the image of this city. This comes back to what a lot of these fine people have said tonight. We, and again I mean you, have a moral obligation to stand with the people of Boroughville who have come out overwhelmingly in opposition to this project. So are we going to improve or degrade the image of this city by thumbing our nose at our neighbors? Thank you.
Reminder, please hold your applause. Proceed, thank you.
My name is Daniel Linder, 261 Summer Street. I've got a couple of things. I moved here from California. It's a company called Nestle's, and they have all kinds of water rights. Farms are going out of business, people don't have water to water their lawns. Nestle's just taking all their water and using it. Water is not an infinite resource. It needs to be thought of. You vastly reduced the quantity of water you're going to use under natural gas. You will also need to run diesel at points in time. If you do that, you're still using tons of water. Why is that not any of the proposals that I've seen in the reduced water that you're using? Lastly, everything I see on TV about global warming says you need to stop using fossil fuels now. If you don't stop now, the world ends. And that's it, end of the story. What needs to happen, if you want to build an energy plant, build an energy plant. Solar, wind, hydro, whatever. Not fossil fuel. Yeah. Thank you.